Hello guys, welcome back once again in the new video of React Native. And in this video I would like to show you that how we can add React Native vector icons. So first of all, we go inside the browser and type here vector icons React Native. So we just click on the first link. So actually this is the official document of the React Native vector icons. So if you want to show icons in your React Native app, so you can use this. So for installing, we can read all the instructions given here. So first of all, we just need to add this for installing the package. So we just go inside the project and type here and just enter. So it will take few seconds. So package is installed. So we can check in the package.json. So you can check that here, package is installed. So we go inside the package again and check the other instructions. Here for the iOS, we need to follow few other steps. Like we go inside the node module and inside the React Native vector icons, we drag and drop the fonts folder. First of all, we need to open the Xcode, and in the Xcode we just add it for the iOS. So we just open this folder, reveal in finder, and here enter. So we just need to open this file. Yeah, so Xcode is now opened. So the next step is that we go inside the project and here go inside the node modules and find here React Native vector icons. Yeah, so here is the folder of the React Native vector icons. So we just find this, reveal in finder, and here we just open it. And here, so according to the instructions here, go inside the node module and inside the fonts, we just drag and drop it inside the Xcode. So we just open the fonts. So actually this is all the font is exist inside the fonts folder. So we need to open the Xcode here and just drag and drop. So when we are drag and drop, so we need to remember the few steps. So we make sure that app is checked under the add to targets. If adding the whole folders, so check the create groups. So I am adding here the whole folder. So open the Xcode, go inside the fonts folder. So just I am drag and drop the whole folder. So like this. And here we need to check this add to targets, because inside the setup here one line is mentioned, your app is checked under the add to target. So we need to check this. And second, we are dragging the whole folder, so we need to select here create groups and just finish it. So when I am dragging the whole folder, so you can check that all the font is showing here, and inside the build phase you can check your fonts will be show here. So again go inside the browser, and the next point is that inside the info.plist we will add the fonts. So we need to add here all these fonts inside the info.plist. So we just copy all the fonts here. So go inside the info.plist and here just open it as a source code, and here we need to paste all the fonts. So we just, so I am just pasting here and removing the space. And now we check the property list in this view. So here we will check fonts provided by the application will be show all the font here. Yeah, so now this point, yeah, so this step is also completed. And now go inside the package and check the other steps. So the next step is that we need to create a file, create react-config.js. So we just copy this and go inside the project, and we need to create this file. So one thing we should be remember that this file will be created at the root of the React Native project. So we just click here, and here we'll just create a file and just name it react-native-config.js. So file is created here, and this code we will add here like this. Yeah, so now all the steps we have completed for the iOS. So first we just run it on the iOS. Now go inside the terminal and go inside iOS and just run here port install. Yeah, so now port is completed, and run the application again. Go inside the root of the project and run here npx react native run iOS. So it will take few seconds, we just wait for it.
A few moments later.
Package is not creating any issue, so we need to show the icon. So for this we go inside the package and check here how we can show the icon. Yeah, so we just can copy this and we can use it inside our application now directly. So for just testing we are using it and want to show any icon. So suppose I want to show this icon, so I can copy this and directly we can use. Suppose this is the forget password and I want to show here any icon, so I am using here. So color we can give here green color and just save it. Yeah, so finally you can check that the icon is showing here. So you can show any icon you want. Suppose you want to any other icon, so we need to go inside the directory of the vector icons. So here we can just open this link and check the icons list here. Yeah, so all the icons is given here. Suppose you want to show any icons from here. So we are using here the type of the icon is here font. So suppose you want to show any icon, so we just type the header of the icon like end design and just we copy here and design, and you can choose any icon. Suppose you want to show cloud upload, so we just copy this icon and we can use here. Suppose we are using here rocket, so we can now use cloud upload and we can commenting. You can use it also with the other name, but now we are using icon, so we can change it and we can save it. Yeah, so now this icon will be show here. So you can give here any color you want. Suppose we are using, suppose here green color, we can use here any color. Suppose we are using here black color, so the black icon will be show here like this. So like this we can use the icon in our iOS application. So the next step is that we will use the icon in the Android application. So for the Android we need to add few other extra steps, like we will read here all the instructions for the Android. So for the Android we will go inside the Android build.gradle, and here we will add this line. So one thing we should be remember here, we go inside the app.gradle. So in the Android, we have the two Gradle files. One is the outside from the app and one is inside of the app. So we will go inside app and click here build.gradle, and in the Gradle we just need to add this file. So the vector icons we will add here. So it is just for the customization, and if you want to take few categories, but this is only just for the customization, but we are using here for the all type of icons, so we need not to use this. So we will just use this line, and now we will save it. And now the application we will run on the Android. So first we just remove this node and we'll run the application for the Android. So if you want to run your application on the Android, so one thing you should be remember that your environment for the Android application must be set. So if you did not set your environment for the Android application, so I have given the link in the description box, so you can follow all the instructions and you can set your environment for the Android application also. So I am just running here for the Android, so we just need to add this and just enter.
A few moments later.
Yeah, so you can check that the icon is showing in the Android and iOS in the both application, because we are showing the same icon in the Android as well as in the iOS. So like this you can use the vector icons in your application. So I hope this video is very helpful for understanding the vector icons and how we can use in our application. So if you like this video, please like, share and subscribe the channel.